Navjot Singh Sidhu has finally arrived for the tea party. It seems that is his car. Yes, it is his car, and that's Navjot Singh Sidhu who's arrived for the tea party. What we are expecting right now, and of course these are only murmurs, because now there seems to be a push within all the MLAs, at least publicly, to project that the Congress is one on board, are both the Chief Minister and the newly minted President of the Congress Party. That is Navjot Singh Sidhu, who's filing in, refusing to take any questions. Word is in that he might, in front of his MLAs, maybe not seek an apology, but try and strike a reconciliatory note with the captain of all the rancor that has taken place over the last few months. So this is what it looks like right now. Hectic activity outside the Punjab Bhavan. All of this, viewers, is going to shift very soon to the Congress Bhavan, because that is where the coronation, the anointment of Navjot Singh Sidhu, along with four working presidents, will take place. I want to cut across right now to my colleague Manjeet, who is joining us outside the Congress Bhavan. These are visuals, everybody trying to get that money shot to read body language of Navjot Singh Sidhu, who's finally come in. Everybody wanting to see what is his body language. He refused to take any questions, just waved out to the press. But yeah, that's his car. And Navjot Singh Sidhu has arrived after most MLAs have already filtered in. He, viewers, would be the new president of the Congress in Punjab. What it tantamounts to, what it brings, 6 months before elections, only time will tell. Whether it's a masterstroke by the Congress High Command or a big gamble or a blunder, we'll only know when that last vote is counted in 6 months, when Punjab goes to elections. So I want to cut across right now to my colleague Manjeet Sehgal. A fair amount of chaos and pandemonium here. Everybody in a flurry to try and get in a reaction from Navjot Singh Sidhu. But I want to cut across to Manjeet. Manjeet, we're at the Punjab Bhavan now. Lots of hectic activity here. It'll all shift in the next 1 hour to the Congress Bhavan, where you are stationed. What are you witnessing around you? Is there a sense, Manjeet, of celebration? Because, you know, what we're picking up here is very strange. This is not somebody who's won an election. This is not somebody who's been anointed as the chief minister candidate. It's, somebody's been given the post of the Congress president in Punjab. Is there a sense of celebratory mode in the Congress Bhavan as well, where you are?
Well, Preeti, we are outside Punjab Bhavan. Yes, as you said, there was a celebration. There, the leaders belonging to Navjot Singh Sidhu camp were in a celebratory mood even before Navjot Singh Sidhu was announced as a new Punjab Congress Committee chief. We have just seen Navjot Singh Sidhu entering Punjab Bhavan, and before Navjot Singh Sidhu, another arch rival, Brahm Mohindra, who is the cabinet minister and holding the charge of local bodies, which was once given to Navjot Singh Sidhu, has also entered Punjab Bhavan. Brahm Mohindra had backed
Punjab. Okay, Manjeet, I'm going to... Manjeet, can I, Manjeet, I'm going to just come in. And the reason, Manjeet, I'm just dipping in is I just want to get, give our viewers a sense. Coming in right now is the Chief Minister of Punjab, Captain Amrinder Singh. His cavalcade is pulling in right now. Not yet, though, yes, but a steady stream of MLAs. But we are expecting the captain's cavalcade to pull in any time right now. He's left for the Punjab Bhavan from his residence. He lives, the official residence of the Chief Minister of Punjab is just about a kilometer down the same road of where Punjab Bhavan is. So the minute you get out on the left, it's right there. He was waiting, viewers, is what we are being told, and understandably so, because there are a lot of egos involved, and in politics, egos are very, very frail. He was waiting for the visuals to stream in of Navjot Singh Sidhu to come in. Only then, now he's making his way. 90% of the MLAs, which are 80, 77 of the Congress, 3 came from the AAP. They're all already inside, last few filtering in. Navjot Singh Sidhu already in. And what we are awaiting right now is Captain Amrinder Singh, the Chief Minister, to come. And I want to cut across back to Manjeet. Manjeet, egos are frail, already hurt, bruised, where the last few months have taken, with what has gone down in the last few months. Captain Amrinder Singh on his way here, From here, Manjeet, they will all be moving en masse together, at least publicly, to show that the entire Congress camp is together towards the Congress Bhavan for the coronation of Navjot Singh Sidhu.
Yes, Prithi, we have witnessed the bitter fighting between the two rival camps during the past 2 months. But now, after the intervention of the party high command, sources telling us that two prominent leaders, one Priyanka Gandhi and Harish Rawat, the party general secretary, were constantly in touch with the chief minister, Captain Amrinder Singh, and requesting him to join the installation ceremony of Navjot Singh Sidhu. Secondly, Captain Amrinder Singh's stance was also being viewed against the party high command's action that was also not in line with the party high command. So these were the facts which compelled or motivated Captain Amrinder Singh to forget his stance for time being. Maybe this could be a temporary truce, but both the camps, be it Navjot Singh Sidhu, Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh, are trying to present.
I want to show, right, Manjeet, I want to just show for our viewers on how the, you know, the wheels within wheels in the Punjab Congress still roll. Why do I say that? Can you see right outside these band of men in the white kurta pajamas? All of them are MLAs of the Congress party. They are actually waiting for Captain Amrinder Singh to come in, and only then will they go inside with him. So, like I said, you know, while the ones who are supporting Sidhu or openly had supported Sidhu have already walked in with him inside. So, technically, the show of strength still continues, because look at what's happening right behind me. These MLAs refusing to enter, you know, the building, which is the Punjab Bhavan, where an invitation has been given out by Captain Amrinder Singh to all the MLAs. Now, the ones that had publicly shown loyalty to Navjot Singh Sidhu are sitting inside the Punjab Bhavan with Navjot Singh Sidhu, waiting for the captain to come in. Those who have clearly now seem to pledge allegiance to Captain Amrinder Singh are waiting for their captain to roll in with his cavalcade and will only go in with him. So this is what the entire situation where the Congress lot in Punjab is. There are wheels within wheels. All is not well. There might be an attempt to portray that public picture that all is well. If you can see, they're still waiting. They're refusing to go inside. I want to cut across back to Manjeet to get an opinion on this. Manjeet, you know, we keep talking about that, you know, today is this attempt by the Congress to show that all is well, that both camps have come together. You know, Sidhu and Amrinder Singh are finally on the same page. Clearly not. Like I said, even where I am standing, Manjeet, the Sidhu loyalists sitting inside the Punjab Bhavan with him, while the ones who pledged allegiance to the captain are waiting outside, waiting for the captain to come in, and only then they will go in.
Yes, indeed, Prithi, this is a sort of show of strength by the two rival camps. Navjot Singh Sidhu and his supporters have already entered the Punjab Bhavan. Captain Amrinder Singh's supporters are waiting for Captain Amrinder Singh, and both the rival factions, be it Navjot Singh Sidhu or Captain Amrinder Singh, are here for a show of strength. Though the message to the party high command will be that we are united, and efforts made by both the rivals is to send a right message to the Congress cadres that there is no factionalism in the Congress party. For time being, this is a truce. This may be temporary, but both the factions are now trying to present a united face among the party cadre, which were confused during the past 2 months when two leaders were constantly attacking each other. Even Navjot Singh Sidhu had questioned the functioning of Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh in 150 tweets, which according to Captain were derogatory in nature. Navjot Singh had questioned functioning of the Chief Minister, and the biggest allegation was that Captain had colluded with the Badals. There were many failures as well, which were listed by Navjot Singh Sidhu. That also includes the desecration of the holy books like Guru Granth Sahib and other scriptures. The other issue was the corruption and the false promises which were made by the Congress Party. Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh, according to Navjot Singh Sidhu and his camp, failed to fulfill these false promises. 18 false promises were also listed before the three-member panel by Sidhu and his camp. The party high command has also directed Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh to fulfill all these false promises before the elections. Only 6 months are left. There are challenges before Navjot Singh Sidhu and Chief Minister as well. It will not be easy for the party to seek the votes, as some of the false promises, major false promises, including jobs to every household, have not been fulfilled so far. There is anti-incumbency against the Congress government. So all these challenges are before the Congress party, and banking on these failures of Congress government, the opposition parties like Aam Aadmi Party and Shiromani Akali Dal can benefit. That is why the party high command is constantly intervening and trying to unite both the factions so that the harm that has been caused to the party during the past 2 to 3 months can be mitigated. So efforts of the party high command used to unite all the factions so that party can focus on the 2022 elections.